Joining me now, Republican Kentucky Senator Rand Paul. Senator, thanks so much for taking the time to join us tonight.
Thanks for having me.
You know, it's always a pleasure to talk to you about media idiocy, which is something that I know you care deeply about. But it's particularly toxic in this moment when we see so many medical officials coming out and saying things that just don't seem to be justified by the science. Why do we see this as a continued problem?
Well, here's the problem. When your government, your so-called government experts are talking about wearing a mask outside, the next thing they'll be doing is saying, and you need to wear a mask when you're by yourself in the car because some of the COVID germs might still be floating around in your car when others get out. But when it so defies common sense, people are going to quit listening to them. I mean, Biden telling us that on July 4th, we may be able to gather with two or three other people as long as we're still wearing our masks, even if we've been vaccinated. Nobody believes that. And there is no science. In fact, all of the science shows that the vaccines are working very well, that very few hospitalizations, almost no deaths, and really that the people who've been vaccinated are not spreading it. They're also showing through the science, even from Dr. Fauci's own institute, that if you've gotten the disease, you're also immune to not only the disease you had, but also to the variants as well. So they need to pay attention to the science, and they need to quit saying, oh, but what if it changes into the Spanish flu? What will we do? What will we do? It's like, well, when that happens, let us know, Dr. Fauci. But if you don't have a study that proves any of this, then you're just, it's all conjecture. And that's my point, is that the government should have the mandate. The burden should be on the government to prove to us why we should be wearing a mask still.
I don't know if you saw this today, Senator Paul, but Joe Biden participated in this conference call with all of these different world leaders, and he was the only one who was wearing a mask. Every other world leader was normal, sitting in front of their Zoom calls, etc., talking to each other. It looks at a certain point ridiculous, and it seems like it's pandemic theater as opposed to based in the science.
Well, because it is theater, he forgot that this theater was so ridiculous that people would call him out on it. Because here's the thing is, if I want to go visit the White House, Republicans and Democrats who go visit, even though they've all been vaccinated or had the disease, they're being tested with a deep sinus test, and they're being told they have to wear the N95 mask to go in the White House, even though they've all been vaccinated. So there is no science behind any of this. It's fear-mongering, but it also has a deleterious effect in that it's discouraging people from getting the vaccine because they're saying, well, if the vaccine doesn't mean anything, it doesn't seem to have any protective benefit, you get no benefits, you can't quit wearing the mask. Some people are saying, why should I get it? And I think that's the wrong attitude, but this is what's coming from Biden and the so-called scientists that he's putting forward.
I know that you are concerned, as I am, that this pandemic is going to lead to restrictions on human freedom that last well beyond it's dealt with both via vaccine and achieving herd immunity. What can we do to make sure that we don't have a sort of permanent pandemic-sized state, one that really crushes our ability to live as free Americans?
The only thing we can do is push back. I think you saw the video of the young teacher in Georgia whose video went viral saying she wants to know why her six-year-old's still wearing a mask. It was a very passionate speech. In fact, I think I might even endorse her for the U.S. Senate. She was such a good speaker, and we need people to push back. But that's what it's going to take is everyday ordinary citizens saying, tell me why. Tell me why my kid has to keep wearing a mask. And the thing is there is no good science on any of this. We don't need people in charge of giving us advice or giving us mandates who are talking about zero risk. In a free society, we all make our own judgment, and what we want is low risk. We want an acceptable risk. We want the risk that we take to get in a car. So if COVID is less likely to kill us than getting in a car, maybe we could make our own decisions for a change.
Mm-hmm. You know, this vaccine passport issue is all obviously something that's pretty live, and a number of different states have taken some steps against these. What else would you like to see in terms of preventing the encroachment of the state on our ability to work and to travel?
Well, people are going to have to understand that ultimately a lot of us aren't happy with all these mandates. I know many people who don't have to fly, just won't fly because they don't want to be told what to do, to wear a mask for several hours on a plane. Major League Baseball, So they say all Republicans are racist because of the Georgia voting election law. Then they charge $150. And then they say, well, when you come to the game, you still have to wear a mask outside. Mm-hmm. There's no science saying anybody is getting this disease outside or that it's widely transmitting. The only real instances that they've been able to show were in enclosed spaces, you know, a choir practice where you're with, you know, 20 people for an hour, where they did show significant spread in enclosed spaces. But nobody's shown that kind of study outside. Mm-hmm. So there's no proof. It's just Dr. Fauci saying, what if you might get it? You might get it. Really, he needs to prove to us. He needs to show us the studies as to why we have to be there with a mask on outside.
Senator Paul, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.